Hey guys, it's-a me, El Papa, aka Mario Kappa. Nah, he's just help our dude. So this is I wanna try to make a series, like a playlist series with games that we lost in, and I'm gonna go over the games that we lost and see what mistakes were made, and maybe you guys gonna improve from my mistakes. I'm gonna improve for sure, so this is like a win-win from everybody. Somebody requested this. I thought it's a pretty good idea, and if you guys like it, I'm gonna continue making them. And yeah, jump right into it, bros. Let's go. And I'm gonna watch the talents a bit. So root, it's fine. If he's melee wings, he's gonna be only one root. I also think I went calming in this one, and my bags are so ugly. Okay, bum bum bum. Let's speed up this a bit. Okay, slow, 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 slow. Very slow. I see warrior. I root warrior. I don't know what warrior is doing. He seemed to going me, and then he went to boom me. Okay, booming. Yeah, Boomy went towards me a bit. They pop all their cooldowns. Okay, let's slow down a bit. Let's slow down a bit. Okay, I'm gonna pause this. I got gripped, stunned. They popped everything. Warrior cooldowns, DK cooldowns. They dropped me to like 20%. Actually, more. I think this is like 30 plus percent. And I got interrupted as well. It's fine. I use Ascendance. I have Totem down. Warrior cooldowns are over, so there is no big hits anymore. So my Totem actually absorbs a lot more stuff. And I can pretty much free cast now since they both interrupted, so there are no interrupts right now. So I can free cast, which I do. I'm gonna top everybody since Ascendance is up, except Boomkin that got cloned. It's fine. I'm gonna dispel that Hodge. Okay, so far so good. I should actually start getting distance, and they would probably swap off me. Yeah, they did. The DK actually stole Cyclone, but it was DR'd. It's fine. Okay, I hex the guy, and I should have Earthshield before that healing wave. So yeah, that's fine, I guess. He's still pretty healthy and they have no kicks. So yeah. They are blind because the DK cloned me and the warrior fear before, so whatever. Imagine if he didn't DR. And now we got bubble, right? Or not yet. Yeah, we did get bubble, yeah. So the warrior tried to go Holy Paladin. The Boomy is still on the DK, so that swap did nothing, and the warrior is still chasing the Holy Paladin, so this is awkward. I got gripped in again. I'm gonna jump away, and they both are chasing me. I'm gonna probably swap her shield. Yes, I do. I'm very fine right now. They have zero kicks, and I think. Okay, they should have maybe connected on Holy Paladin, both of them, but. The Boomy is still on the DK, the warrior is on Holy Paladin, he got freedom, I tried to get it. I didn't gonna go for a healing wave, I should have reapplied Earthshield on the Boomkin Rider. He's still tanky as fuck. I mean, it's not really that important to reapply as soon as possible or Earthshield on the Boomy because this shit can happen. You can get swapped on in a Hodge, so this is pretty scary. It's like Hodge into double kicks or triple kicks with pet stun and another DR stun and grip. It's really you can die. You can actually die in a swap like this. So it's really important to make sure shield is on you when the stun is upcoming. See, I had Earthshield on my Senna. I still got pretty low. Okay, they went Paladin some more, they feared him. Okay, so he's there on clone. I should have sheared that thingy. I think I should have sheared a lot more since the Paladin was near us most of the time, but I also was in trouble kinda, so yeah, maybe it's fine. So bottom line so far. They either should have stick on the Death Knight, because he's pretty much the most squishy in this game, or they should have trained the Paladin after the bubble. Like he was like sometimes here, his position was sometimes here or here, so he had like a weird positioning, pretty much in the middle of arena. So I guess that time was a good time to swap on him, but it was only the warrior, the Bumi was still on the Death Knight, or just CC him, like clone him or stun him or try to root beam. But I don't think he was. Yeah, he wasn't root beam. There's a Bash DR over here, so he was Bash for sure. I think in this matchup, and probably against every healer except Druid, root beam should be the go-to talent for Boomkins right now. Okay, so they tried to go me with that burst. I was fine. I just walled and completely fine after that. Warrior went back on the Bumi. The Death Knight is still trying to kill me. They do a split strategy kind of for a bit. I actually get a hex since I see the Bumi soloing. I mean, they're both on Death Knight right now. That was trinket from Hex and Sack plus Corp Shield, so that's a big overlap again, because they did it before, like Sack and Corp Shield. Okay, whoa. So this was an important part of the game, I think. I think he's gonna die soon, actually. Whoops. I fucked up. Okay, gonna cut this in the edit. Dos patru. Got a full hex, everything it's Gucci so far. They're still spread. Okay, they overlapped over there. Okay, that was a pretty big overlap, but Boomkin is half HP. I have Urshield on myself. I'm casting on myself as well. I see the Paladin right next to me. I know he has Hodge available. And as soon as he's gonna finish this cast, I'm expecting a Hodge. I'm not playing grounding, so I cannot ground this. This is like a perfect example when to ground. You see the DK moving towards you. Warrior is already having pressure on the Bumi, but he has charge or leap available. And I'm in the open, which is fine, since that's useful for the Boomkin, because he can peel. He actually tries to cast Cyclone, and there's only the DK pommel available. No warrior pommel, but I think he still has reflect, but yeah. So they use cooldown, they cannot die. Warrior is full HP, Paladin still has one bop available, probably. He's like pretty high HP. DK cannot die, it has Sock and Corp Shield, so he takes no damage. Paladin take no damage, so they're completely fine right now. So I think this is when they should go for a huge play. Like, I was afraid of what happened earlier in this match. They did Hodge into Stormbolt, and I almost died. But I do have Trinket right now, so I should be fine, and I have Trinket Link, so I shouldn't die. Okay, so I'm expecting a Hodge on me. Okay, I swapped her shield. I had Orb Shield, but I just refreshed it. Okay, so that was a stun. They both stun. They overlap stun. He didn't grip. I thought he's gonna grip as well, but he didn't grip. He got Asphyxiate plus the Holy Paladin stun, so they overlapped as well. And I think I'm gonna trinket this, and I am. Okay, I trinket this. Paladin is still close to me. I don't have Hex yet, but he's in the middle of arena. and he doesn't have bubble, and like the Boomy popped cooldowns, and I think DK still has sack, or maybe had, maybe not anymore. Yeah, he still had sack for like 4 more seconds. So this is a prime example to go Paladin. Okay. Problem with this scenario. I was afraid of what happened earlier, and I wanted to make sure I have Urshield on myself. When I trinketed, I should have pressed Urshield on the druid, but because I used Urshield while I still had Urshield, I actually had a cooldown. I had 2 seconds cooldown on my Urshield, so I couldn't use on the guy before of this blind. So that was pretty bad. And that's a way too late Barskin as well. Usually Boomkins are tanky. I thought he's gonna survive, you know? But he used Barskin so late. If he used Barskin right when I got blinded, like the exact second, or not really the exact second, like maybe 1 second into my blind. Just 1 second into my blind. You have time to react, right? If he used Barskin right there, I would have been able to like link him or maybe top him, because he wouldn't be so low. Yeah. So this was unfortunate, man. So a few mistakes this game were like choosing the wrong targets to go on. They should either commit to the Holy Paladin. Oh, whoops. They should either commit to the Holy Paladin or train only the Death Knight and CC the Holy Paladin more. There was no root beam, so that kind of sucked. But even so, I still got hexes off, and maybe if he would like, if we try to CC the Paladin more, I would have an easier time to get more hexes even. And you know, it's easier to keep pressure on the Death Knight since he has to run into open every time. But the Holy Paladin was a pretty good target as well, because he always ran into open and he pretty much stayed in the open for a lot of time. Even when he got swapped on by the warrior, he was still pretty much in the opener. I mean, he was in the Boomkins line of sight. So yeah, I played scared in this game. I didn't want to die, so I fucked off my Urshield cooldown. That's my biggest mistake. And if I trinket Urshield or trinket Link, but he was healthy. I mean, when I trinket, he was half HP, so a Link would have done nothing. What, like maybe 15% more HP? So the correct scenario would be like not even trinketing, not even trinketing, but you know, I just, whatever, I'm gonna trinket that, you know, to keep the pressure up, because you know the sack is gonna go off and we would have been completely fine. And yeah, didn't want to boom it to use Barskin, so I just, you know, trinket and try to use something. But I trinket and I was slow. I wasn't actually slow. I swapped Urshield on myself before the Hodge, right before the Hodge, so I had cooldown on Urshield, and I tried to trinket Urshield, but I forgot I swapped on myself and it didn't work, so I got blinded instantly, and that's when the Boomy should have used the Barskin.